Irving Seller was contemplating this dream of building an iconic tower at London Bridge. It was seen as an area ready for regeneration. It sits on top of, alongside, one of the biggest transit terminuses in London.
A government white paper emerged which said they would encourage high-density development, providing properties were close to transport hubs. Well, the building we bought sat right next to and partly on top of London Bridge Station. The idea of having a multi-use building, a vertical town, hit me at the time. If we're going to build big, then we should have a mix of uses.
And I thought, well, we should be doing that. We're the people that should be engineering that. We are the best. So I made an appointment, and it was convincing a client that they can trust you on what is their dream.
I think it was a bit about belief in the building, because I remember people saying to me, it'll never be built. No one's ever going to build it.
Once he had established an architect in Renzo Piano, he then spent a long time convincing the establishment that this was a great idea for London.
We had all the odds working against us. The planning odds, the public inquiry. There was complete disbelief this would ever happen. So with a sort of a fair amount of aggressive charm, aggression probably more than charm, we worked our way through it. Obviously, this had to be engineered in a way that met every possible need for the future.
The kind of stereotype approach is that the engineer is worried about numbers, and the architect's worried about the colour, and all the builder cares about is building it quickly. On the Shard, it wasn't like that. The architect did listen when we talked to him about our concerns about the structure. We listened to him with his concerns about aesthetics, and the contractor was open to discussions about how we could maybe build things slightly differently.
By looking at the form, geometry, and the type of usage of the building, we seek the best possible engineering and structural solution.
The client had this ambition of 900,000 square feet of lettable floor area, and we had to pack that floor area in.
Our solution was to say, yes, an office is best as a steel frame, but for a hotel and for residential use, typically a concrete frame building is the way that one would go.
So we changed to concrete floors for the residential, and that reduced our floor-to-floor heights and allowed us to push extra floors in.
At the same time, we were able to eliminate, say, £3 million worth of masstone damper in the building. So this was all about coming up with ideas that complement the architecture of the building.
This building had other drivers in play, including the idea of having it physically complete before the Olympics.
We've built basements top-down before, but what was different about the Shard was that we built the core top-down. It was a difficult thing to do. It had never been done before, but now everybody seems to be doing it.
That approach is considered to have saved us about 3 months on the programme and brought this completion date forward from after the Olympics to before the Olympics.
We had a big challenge building the spire safely and economically.
For that reason, this was all built off-site. All the parts were then marked and taken to bits in the knowledge that at least it had fitted together once.
It's been good to see the positive effect that the Shard has had on the London Bridge area.
I feel like we have given something to a community.
We spent over £62 million in public realm, including the new bus station, new station concourse. This was the nucleus of the real ambition, which still continues, to create a new quarter, a new district for London.
It's a beautiful story. It tells you that if you really want to do it, you could do it, but it needs everybody to work together.
It's got global recognition. It has won more awards than I think any other building.
The Shard project gave us the opportunity to demonstrate that we're a world-class engineer. And the pride that we have in accomplishing that design and that eventual output is enormous.
We haven't had our Eiffel Tower, we haven't had our Empire State, but we've now got the Shard. And I'm privileged with my team to have delivered it.